Day two of the pond dredge. Let's get started.
So it's going pretty good, getting the trucks loaded. Well, trucks, the truck, not plural. One truck, multiple loads. Getting this cut out, so it can only kind of stay in those ruts. So I'm gonna try to work this section out right here, cut it out, and then I think I can jump over and have the truck just back down that old fence line side and load out right there and avoid all the wetness over there. So I was trying to take some of this mud and kind of mix it in with each load. I'll get a couple scoops of mud and mix in with the dry dirt. By the time he dumps it out and I blade over it with a dozer, it should become a somewhat decent material to spread out. I've learned over the years, if you haul a bunch of dry dirt and a few wet loads and mix it all between, you'll just be driving along with the dozer when you go to spread it out and just sink completely out of sight. That by mixing all the mud together. Still not filling the truck all the way full just because the ground doesn't need all that extra weight. Although I'm putting a lot more in than I was to start with yesterday. I'm still easing off a bucket or two on it. take out. That stuff right there got really, really wet. Must be like a underground spring or something. Be good for the pond though. Keep it full. Loads and I'll have all the material dug out of the pond. last load will dump up there so I can fill in all those ruts. Load.
Pond's dug out. I'm going to take the dozer and probably run around the edges and grade them out before I cut that water in there. That way I can kind of, I'm not pushing down next to the water.
Then grade everything out. Pond's done. Hop on the dozer, start cleaning this up, and going and spreading out all the dirt we hauled out back. the prettiest in the world, but as wet as that mud was, I think it spread out okay. Enough for a cow pasture, get some grass growing on it, let the cow stomp it all down. Be fine and dandy. I'm gonna go dress up around the pond while he rakes that pile of dirt there down. Last pass. This is probably some of the most aggravating dirt to grade out I've graded in a long time. It's just so much topsoil with roots and grass. And she's got somebody that's going to come here in a week or so and drag over it and disc it up and plant it. So not too worried about it getting it pristine and everything. But I got that little swale roughed in back over there, and we got the overflow put in this morning. I'm just running around the edges, getting everything cleaned up. As you saw yesterday, I pulled that mud back and kind of smeared it into the bottom to kind of cover everything. So the water's got to come up about another five and a half feet, and it'll be full, and water will be all the way up here to the top of the bank. So took a lot of mud out of here, and they have a nice deep little irrigation pond now. Finished dressing everything up and get the equipment out of here. There it is. All done. Got a really wet spot right there. There's a spring, and the more you touch it, the more it turns to liquid. So kind of left that alone. Water's going to come all the way up here to this edge, so it'll hide everything else. And come back and drag everything and put some seed out. It's a whole lot deeper than it was. So water used to be about right in there. Got all this dug back so that now it'll come full depth all the way to the bank.